detecting a massive object emerging from hyperspace.
With The Mandalorian about to wrap up and The Rise of Skywalker finally out of the way, figured it's about time I did my review for this series as a whole. Now, these videos are going to be a little bit shorter than normal, so that's just kind of a bit of preparation going into this. They are going to be each covering a single episode at a time, and they will be covering spoilers, so if you haven't watched the show, you might want to click away now. Starting off, I think we have a great introduction to the Mandalorian as a character. The first scene where he's going after his bounty is absolutely fantastic. It's a great introduction, and it of course ends with him being frozen in carbonite, which I think is a little bit of a nice nod to the original trilogy. And speaking of references, this show does feel like it's in Star Wars, but it doesn't feel like it's trying to be. Unlike most other properties within the, the Star Wars canon, it doesn't feel the need for abundant references everywhere. It just feels like it's part of Star Wars. There's really no easy way to explain it. It's just kind of how it feels to every individual person watching it. And a great thing about the show is that it's very grounded. It's very small scale. It doesn't feel like it's attempting to tell a bigger story. It just feels like it's very small. It's very personal. It's only following the Mandalorian and his quest and his journey. Yes, there are broader scopes, obviously the ending, but it still feels like it's a very character-driven and small-scale story, which is a nice change of pace from the majority of Star Wars. Even the Clone Wars and Rebels, which is fantastic, started out small and ended up being a very big galaxy-wide adventure. There is one big reference, which is shown throughout the entirety of the show, is the Mandalorian's hate for droids, and it's shown via flashbacks of his life as a child during the Clone Wars. You see super battle droid and you see droid gunships. It's really nice, and obviously it's kind of something that, you know, while this show does feel very original trilogy-esque, it only takes place 5 years after the fact, it's still nice that they include a little bit of something for the younger fans. The action is fantastic. I absolutely loved IG-11. Obviously, he does come back later in the show. We'll get to that in future videos, but I absolutely love his action. I love how his movements and action feels very robotic. It doesn't feel like a human puppeteering or acting as a droid. It feels very much like a droid, how it would move. So did lag a bit when the Mandalorian is attempting to learn how to ride the Blurgs, but that's a very small gripe and an otherwise great premiere to a great show. All the action is great. The reveal at the end that the quarry that he is chasing is in fact a baby of the same species as Yoda, Yaddle, and one character from Knights of the Old Republic. I thought that was very interesting. There's unknown implications to the Star Wars series as a whole after that. It introduces a lot of new possibilities that, of course, are touched later on in the show, and certain things are eliminated as options later on in the show, which we will get to then. But yeah, if you don't have Disney Plus, I would recommend getting it. If you have Verizon, you can actually get the first year free. Aside from that, it's $70, I think, for a year. It's less altogether if you buy a three-year bundle. I don't know if I'd really recommend that, but I certainly recommend you get Disney Plus. If you're in a part of the world that currently doesn't offer it till March, I am sorry. But to everyone else who has the ability to, I definitely recommend you get it. It's a great show. You guys can expect more videos, each one being short little videos going into each episode and my quick little review of them. And, you know, we'll just see how this goes. But I'm certainly very excited for the show right now. Thanks for watching, and as always, I'll see you again next time.
You don't know the power of 1980.